many of today's mid-sized luxury sedans fetishize sportiness, but there are still hordes of customers in this space for whom sports car challenging Nürburgring lap times, quick steering, and firm suspension tuning matters little. These folks would be well served by the newest Mercedes-Benz E-Class, which boldly goes its own way by placing comfort before sportiness. Our first encounter with the 2017 E-Class took place in crowded Lisbon, Portugal, and largely focused on its arsenal of semi-autonomous and active safety technologies. We've since had a much longer run at the GNU E-Class in US Spec E300 4MATIC form in California and, having already covered its self-driving features and tech in great detail from Portugal, this review homes in on the Benz's merit as an automobile, one driven by a human. The incredible not sporty sedan. Merriam-Webster's definition of luxury is a condition or situation of great comfort, ease, and wealth. While the E-Class's optional ability to drive itself for up to 60 seconds at a time would seem to fit that definition, so, too, does the car's comportment when your hands are on the wheel and your feet work the pedals. Everything about the primary controls feels numb to minimize driver effort or fuss. In any drive mode, a range that includes comfort, eco, sport, sport plus, and individual settings, the steering wheel spins with a positive, albeit liquid, damped movement. As cornering forces build, so does the steering's sense of weightiness, but the delta in effort isn't huge and there's no pesky road feel to jiggle your fingers. The sportier drive modes raise the baseline steering heft somewhat, but the E never requires that the driver throw a shoulder into it. Similarly, the brake pedal moves through a squishy, pudding-like resistance after an initial zone of free play yet responds to the first tap of pressure. Mercedes-Benz offers three suspension setups for the E300, a pair of traditional steel-sprung configurations with continuously adaptive, but not driver-adjustable, electronic dampers and the $1,900 air suspension choice, all of which can be described as comfort-oriented. For the E300 Sport, the adaptive dampers are slightly firmer, while the no-cost E300 Luxury trim is tuned more softly. The Sport and the Luxury are otherwise pretty much the same, although with different grille designs, the E's brain works with the dampers to continuously adapt to changing conditions, firming things up in corners and relaxing them when driving in a straight line. For the most part, the ride is compliant and composed. Over pockmarked pavement, however, the electronics weren't quick enough to stiffen rebound damping, the resistance to allowing the suspension to decompress, say, as the car crests a hill, or to settle the suspension after larger dips in the road, leading to some secondary bobbing. The optional air springs tamp down this tendency while adding even more polish to the ride and additional driver control over the suspension's stiffness. A slight bobbing sensation when quickly throwing the E300 into corners or when the suspension settled on the far side of large road heaves remained present, even in the firmest Sport Plus drive mode. Given the E300's utter lack of sporting potence, the cast-sitting tendency is easily forgiven, particularly given that it doesn't take away from the car's secure handling and confident braking. It may not reach the level of fun, but the E300 4MATIC doesn't go all catawampus when thrown around. Are you not infotained? Sitting atop to the E300 suspension is an attractive, if slightly too familiar, body. Simply put, the E-Class looks like a C-Class you're standing too close to, or an S-Class you're a few steps farther away from. But the familial relationship is welcome in the well-isolated and quite attractive interior filled with soft-touch plastics, real wood, and slivers of metal. We sampled only the incredibly comfortable active multi-counter front seats, a lovely pair of chairs filled with electronically controlled air bladders that offer a wide range of positions and back massage functions. There are even six bladders in each lower cushion that support a butt massage setting wherein air bladders gently juggle your cheeks like a grocery shopper determining the heavier of two cantaloupes. The cabin's centerpiece is the standard high-resolution 12.3-inch central display running Benz's command infotainment interface and Apple CarPlay and Android Auto integration, along with the 7.0-inch driver information display between a pair of analog gauges, all of which is fitted to a large rectangular pod mounted high on the dashboard. a second 12.3-inch screen can replace the gauge cluster's pair of analog gauges and smaller driver information display for $850, but this requires the most comprehensive and expensive of the E300's three available premium packages, effectively bringing the total cost to add that second screen to $12,100. The premium 1 and 2 packages cost $3,950 and $7,650 and are supplemented by only a handful of individual options, based on the digital gauge cluster's looks, as well as the premium 3 packages' deep roster of must-have features, which include the semi-autonomous gear. We anticipate most of the E300s parked on dealer lots will be so equipped. If you place stock in the luxury of choice, then Mercedes has you covered when it comes to operating the E300's displays. In addition to hard button shortcuts to key menus, radio, media, phone, navigation, and settings, the E300 also responds to voice control inputs, clicks and spins of the command knob on the center console, smartphone-style taps, clicks, and swipes on the touchpad mounted above the command knob, and up, down, left, right swipes and clicks on a pair of thumb-operable touchpads on the steering wheel. Intuitively, the left pad works the driver display, the right manipulates the central display. We preferred using the steering wheel controls, but the knob and the touchpad work well, too, so long as you don't delve too deeply into the system. Dig beyond the first two layers of the menu structure, and things can get fiddly. Luckily, common settings such as radio station tuning, zoom for the navigation map, and seat massage are easily accessed in the first tier. An engine, it has one. Outside of the AMG pedaled, prior performance E43 and the expected E63 variants, the E-Class comes exclusively in 4-cylinder E300 guise. This is worthy of discussion only because most competitors offer optional 6-cylinder engines without forcing buyers to step into AMG equivalents. Ultimately, customers will vote with their wallets on whether a vehicle capable of being optioned to more than $75,000 needs more cylinders, but the low-key engine is appropriately matched to the rest of these dynamic capabilities, even when mated to the 4MATIC drive system like the cars we drove for most of our time in California. The turbocharged 2.0 liters 241 horsepower and 273 pounds-to-foot of torque car on par with the entry-level engines in BMW's 5 Series, Audi's A6, and others, and it contends with an E-Class that's about 150 pounds lighter than before, so acceleration is uneventful but not terribly slow. The engine is almost diesel-like, with the 9-speed automatic transmission doing a fine job of firing off snappy shifts and selecting the right gear to take advantage of the low-down torque. With this sort of power, the 4MATIC all-wheel drive system goes unnoticed, not affecting performance in any way besides contributing traction, and then only in the slipperiest conditions. It adds about 140 pounds to the curb weight and $2,500 to the price. The powertrain's only vices are the faintest hints of 4-cylinder booming in certain low RPM, high gear situations, entering a slight grade on the highway, for example, and the transmission's insistence on passing through fifth gear during full throttle downshifts. Floor the gas pedal while at a cruise, and the transmission will drop from 7th, 8th, or 9th gear all the way to 3rd, but not before briefly hanging up at 5th. We fully expect that 99% of E-Class buyers won't notice or care, even if the foible adds a short delay to red mist passing maneuvers, as does the mace of the 4MATIC all-wheel drive hardware. What will be noticed is the cohesion between the E300's stylish, rich interior, the quiet, coddling comfort as it goes down the road, and the fatigue-combating semi-autonomous features. Every aspect of the E-Class is working toward a singular, overtly luxurious experience. Even the practical stuff isn't overlooked, with plenty of stash space in the cabin and a usefully shaped trunk that can be expanded by way of the standard 40/20/40 split folding rear seat. Backseat passengers have plenty of headroom and greater legroom than before, thanks to the 17 E300's 2.5-inch longer wheelbase. and a quartet of air vents centered on the dashboard, in addition to outboard vents, allows each front passenger to thoroughly air themselves, while still directing AC to the back seats to support the dedicated duo of vents back there. Everything feels well thought out and pragmatic, an entirely predictable result given Benz's record of experience in building fine sedans. Sporty sedans may be the latest fad, but the E-Class, now in its 10th generation, caps a lineage dating back to 1953, and it is comfortable being an unabashedly unsporty luxury sedan.